Hello everyone, welcome back to learnings, and in this video we're going to see how to get the last access time of any file in a folder using UiPath Studio. What that means is at what time the user is accessed the last time the user accessed these files. So if I access this file now, it need to give the current time of when we are actually accessing it. I actually access this and this now, so let us see what are the times that we will get for these two files. Remember the names, which is invoice one and the PDF image. So these two dates should be matched with current date. So watch for it. And before going to that, if you haven't subscribed to our channel, please consider subscribing for more videos. And if you like this video, please give it a like. If you have any other doubts, do mention them in the comment section below. So let us go ahead and build this. First, I need to take an assign activity. It will declare the file path of that particular folder. So let me create a file path variable, and I need to get each and every file from that. So I will use a directory dot get files of, I need to provide the path. So let me copy the path, select the path, come here and paste the path here, and click on OK, and change the variable type to system.string array, string array. Now we will use a for each to iterate through each item in the folder, and we will provide the input as a file path, which is system array of strings. And let me use a message box up here to get the file name, which is item.toString, and I will use an invoke method activity to get the last access time of a file, and the method name here is get last access time. This is the method name, and you need to select target type as system.io.file, and still there is an error, which is because the parameters where we need to pass the input file path, which is item.toString, and hit on OK, and the error is gone. Now let me drag in another message box to display the output time from the invoke method activity, which is the result property here. In the properties panel, you can see a result out argument here. The result is an out argument, and if we create an out argument, let us say last access time, and there is an error popped up because it says as the mismatch of return type, which is date time. But let us see what's the return type here, which is string. So we need to change that to date time, change that to date time, and the error is gone. Now here we need to provide the last access time. So let us save this and let us try to execute this and see what are the times that we are getting. So let me open this. When I last accessed this conversion.pdf, it is 9:15, and then it is 9:15 again. And the demo is 9:15, and the Excel sheet is 9:15, and this invoice is also 9:15, which is 9:15:2020, and 11:56, the last time I accessed this file. In the PDF as well, 9:15. This is the time when I access this, and these are the files where I copied it from another folder and pasted it in this folder. So I access those files, so it is given me this last access file. And let us do a bit different here, and let me go back to my another folder where I haven't accessed those files. So let me copy this path and come back here, change the path, and let us verify how it's gonna come, because those are the files I already accessed because I copied it and pasted it in a different folder. So let us see this. Here you can see it is 7:04 when I last accessed this file. 7:04, 8:24, and 7:04. So This is how you get the last access time of any file in a folder. And that's it for this video. If you like this video, please give it a like. If you have any other doubts, do mention them in the comment section below. Thanks for watching.